Please, Anandaji, speak a little bit about the gurukula system of learning Vedic shastras.
If you are planning to join in a gurukula in olden days, now also there are very few in the remote villages. I cannot name the places or I cannot the things. I can give you later the information, there is no doubt in that one. There are people, they are making such a way of learning. Suppose if you wanted to learn Ayurveda, if you go to a vaidya of the ancient time, he follows it, if gurukula method, then the very first subject taught will be the Vyākaraṇa, Sanskrit Vyākaraṇa. Sanskrit Vyākaraṇa, whole textbook will be taught very clearly, like a person is going to take scholarship in Sanskrit. After that, they will go for the mīmāṁsā śāstra, which deals with the words. After completing the complete knowledge in the words and its aspects of meaning, which can be expressed from a root word, suffix and prefix and other aspects of grammar, the person will be taken to the physical science, which are Nyayavaisheshika and Sankhya.
And just a second, what is the age of the person there?
If you take in olden days, it will be somewhere else in 5 years and 7 years old child will be taken to the gurukula for learning sciences. And by the 16, 17, he will complete the complete whatever be the science he wanted to study, it will be completed by 16, 17, he will be completing. So at the age of 17, he will be a scholar in Ayurveda in olden days.
From 5, 6, 7, the person would be studying for 10, 12 years.
No doubt in that.
Studying the shastras in a manner that we are just like going to an university. It was just the preparation.
There is nothing preparation. He is a small child in his home. He comes directly, the parents leave the child to the gurukula, and his father, mother, sister, everybody is his teacher only. He will not be seeing his parents later. After education only, he can go to his village and he can meet his all fellow men. Relatives. There was a strict rule in that day.
So this is the concept of brahmacarya.
Complete brahmacarya. It is purely brahmacarya. It is called actually brahmacarya. Brahmanam charati iti brahmacarya. That means if you are completely surrendering to the Brahma, you have no relativities, nothing. You are free from that one. You have one aim, that is your ultimate aim. That was the greatest system that which was available in Indian system. It was really great because the person who is coming out of that science will be a complete scholar, not like the university education. In university education, you cannot get. First of all, it is compartmental. When you come to the postgraduation level of Ayurveda, Shalakya Tantra is different, Shalya Tantra is different, Kaya Chikilsa is different, basic principle, Samhita and this one is different. So, how a person can have the complete knowledge in depth? Because postgraduation level, they are specializing too much. It is following the university systems, maybe adapted from westernized culture of life, no doubt on that one, education. But it was not there in Ayurveda in olden days. A person who is studying aṣṭāṅgādaya, he will be a master in all branches, all the eight parts of Ayurveda. Kaya, Bhāgraha, Urdhvānga, Shalyadam, Trajara, Avrusha, all the eight divisions, he will be a master. This is what is lacking in the university education. If you go to a Kaya Chikilsa person, if there is any Shalya problem, he will tell that you go and meet the Shalya person. But it was not the condition in Gurukula education. If you go to a person, Vaidya, he knows your body completely. Just by seeing you, just by the lust or the texture of your skin and eyes, he will find out where your problem is and which dosha is vitiated in you. This was the highest power of the olden Vedas, as they were purely the tapasins of that language. Now it is only a university degree. This is what is
and the, in the university degree, you being a Sanskrit teacher, and you spoke to me that there are some resistance somehow of the Ayurvedic teachers about going deep into the Sanskrit discussions.
Actually,
this is kind of, this is not going to be published in papers. We do not have any kind of stimuli or incentives to develop this true Ayurveda. We are just here making the scheme of things so we can have the support of the finance of the government. People are being like bureaucratic Ayurveda instead of the people that want to learn the deep knowledge and preserve the tradition. How do you, how can you tell us a little bit about this issue that Ayurveda is being diluted, is losing
this is what I told you, you know, when it is brought to the university education, 5.5 years is the scheduled time. You can imagine within 5.5 years you have to complete the whole subject matter in Ayurveda. And the child should know about Ashtangrada, about Charasamhita, about Sushruta Samhita and all the Samhitas. So 5.5 years is not at all sufficient for learning even a single textbook, 1 or 3 or 4 sthanas. So within 4.5 years to 5.5 years, the child has to complete the whole science. So they are choosing some important part from each Samhita and it is added in the curriculum. So that, this is what is the lacking point in the university level.
It's a kind of Ayurvedic Frankenstein, in a sense that there are some things
being... I told you, no, this is the global demand, maybe the global demand, the dilution has been happened in Ayurveda. Maybe because of the global demand, because everything is universitized. So university means 3 years you have to complete your post-graduation, whether you are going to learn it or not. So it's a system that which force you to make it. 3 years only. If you do not complete 3 years, your registration will be cancelled. So you have no other option. Somehow you have to finish the story.
To spill something.
Yeah,
there.
yeah. This problem is there in university education. There is no doubt in that. We cannot simply proudly say that we are completely teaching. It is impossible. It is impossible with the time schedule that which is constituted by, maybe because of the global demand. Otherwise, you need lot of time to learn one Ashtangra. If you are mastering yourself in Ashtangra, devotedly spending lot of time in it, no doubt, afterwards you can learn other textbooks by yourself with the guidance of a teacher. And it is very important. Ayurveda science cannot be studied from textbooks. It needs a teacher directly to explain it to you. As teacher with the knowledge of Sanskrit, with the knowledge of darshanas are very, 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 very important for learning Ayurveda, such sciences, which is a collection of all the sciences like Puranas or whatever it may be, Vedas, everywhere you can see the science. Because it was not at all a single science in olden days, it was their mixture in all the Vedas. Because life is very important for achieving that, you know, the very first loka, ayukamayamanena dharmartha sukha sadhanam ayurveda upadeshesu. So the purpose of learning Ayurveda is having a good health to obtain dharmartha and moksha. That is the purpose of that one. For that, certainly you should have the knowledge in all the sciences. Dharma shastras you should have knowledge, artha shastra you should have knowledge. So without the knowledge of that, learning Ayurveda is a very difficult task. There is no doubt in that one. You need a good teacher who can explain with the references, with the tools like, again I am stressing on that one, Tantra Yukti. There are so many other tools like Arthashraya, Saptakalpana, like this, so many are there tools to learn. This all are there in Ashtangradaya, last chapter Arunadatta is giving in his commentary. And Arunadatta is the person who has given a very good commentary on Ashtangradaya. It is not being completely read in the classes of present university education.
This is
maybe because of the lack of time they are saying, or maybe because the situation that which is not sufficient to learn all these things. I don't feel so. If the students and the community is a little more interested, certainly that can be brought under that. But maybe because of the university education, once again I am telling, it is a formal degree holder is the name we can give for the bachelor's
degree.
Formal
degree holder, yeah. Good. So just so we can close this and go to another point, I would say that around 20-30% of what it's written in this loka is the amount that we learn in our classes. So if we just have this loka there, it's kind of less than half.
Very less. Of the very less information. Very less information. Very,
it's no important doubt. That people have this realization that the book is a minute part of the learning process.
Yeah.
It's just
yeah.
like some topics that yeah, are
that's
listed.
All. That's all. That's
so
all.
We are going to bring a lot of things forth.
Yeah,
it's the
no
seed.
Doubt.
From where the tree will sprout, but it's not completely the tree ready there.
Certainly,
it's certainly. There is some certainly. Some important information there, just like the seed has its own information. But if you look to the seed and say this is the tree, it's not appropriate to
yeah,
say
yeah,
from the yeah, seed yeah, you are yeah. the tree.
See, you if you see the construction of the Ayurveda textbook, you can find out the very first part is sutrasthana. If a person has to teach sutrasthana, he should be a master in other sthanas. Sutra, the word itself means the smallest expression. So if you take a single word, it may have the information that which you have to teach for 2 chapters, 3 chapters when you take the whole textbook. So the person should be master in that word, and that word can bring which information from other sthanas has to be there when he is teaching sutrasthana. This is a very important fact in teaching sutrasthana. Whether the author has written sutrasthana first and then the other sthanas, there is a question. Or after completing all other sthanas, he has come back and written sutrasthana for the pupil to remember the whole information within 30 chapters or 40 chapters, the whole Ayurveda. This is a beautiful way of writing in olden days. This is very important to teach that science, how much a teacher has to work hard. So,
how much
again
is
I am telling,
the information is
certainly,
it
certainly. That, and moreover, if a person is translating the one sloka and its meaning down, you cannot understand anything out of it. It's very less. It is 10% to 20%. You cannot simply imagine something because it is referred so many. If you take Arunadatta's Vyakarana for 1-2 lines, you can see 2 pages.
Yes.
Why he has given 2 pages? Because that much needed to understand the 2 lines. This is very important fact.